Tori here, and today I did a red carpet makeup tutorial that is perfect for this award season. Now I did a glossy red lip paired with a super soft smoky eye that's good for everyday wear. So don't forget to subscribe and let's get into it.
So I'm starting off this makeup look by using my favorite foundation right now, which is the Neutrogena Skin Clearing Foundation, and it actually does clear up your skin, you guys. It's not a myth, it actually works. And also my eyebrows are already filled in, so if you guys want to see my eyebrow routine in depth, that'll be linked down below. Like always, it's a new video, so I guess this is the first video where it's linked down below, but whatever. I'm applying an even coat throughout my entire face using a flat foundation brush, and I love this foundation with a flat foundation brush. It works beautifully together, and it creates the most flawless complexion, perfect for the red carpet. So I'm just using this, and then we are ready to move on to the next step. Anyone that has watched my tutorials before know that I absolutely love cream contouring, but I'm actually doing it rather lightly today. So I'm taking this palette that I always take, and I'm taking a darker shade on a smaller brush, and with very light, thin, not heavy strokes, I'm going to be applying this in the hollows of my cheekbones, and that will make my cheekbones pop out a little bit more. I'm going to apply this to the temples of my forehead to thin down my hairline and also make my forehead look slimmer. I'm also going to be putting this along my lower lip, and this will make it look like there's a shadow under my lip, and then my lip is like so big and so full that it just casts a shadow under my lip. And then I'm going to contour my nose just a little tiny bit to make it a little bit more straight, because when I smile it's still going to go out, so I don't really need to go too heavy on the cream contour on the nose. Moving on to the highlight portion of the contouring and highlighting, I'm going to be doubling up on my concealer and highlighter by applying a lighter concealer to my under eyes. Now I'm also being careful and not applying too light of a concealer to my under eyes, because if you do that, it can actually emphasize your dark circles, and if you're on the red carpet or even at any sort of special event, you definitely do not want your under eye circles emphasized any more than they're already there. So here I'm using it's in the shade NW20, but it's the Pro Longwear Concealer, and I love this because it doesn't crease, so I'm applying this to my under eyes. Before I went on any further with the highlighting, I actually wanted to go in and blend out my contour a little bit just so that they wouldn't mix together and become too muddy. So here I'm going in with a small, dense concealer brush. I forget who this is by. I think it's a Crown brush, but it doesn't really matter because I actually ended up switching it out to a beauty blender because I wasn't a big fan of how it was, you know, buffing out and blending in. So I blend this out with a beauty blender, and I love how it turned out. Alright, so apparently I was really feeling whatever music I was listening to. Actually, I know exactly what I was listening to. It's on my Spotify. But anyway, I'm now going back in with my highlight, and this is the same concealer as before, and I'm applying it down the bridge of my nose to, oh my god, to again elongate my nose a little bit. I'm putting it on my chin to make it a little bit more prominent under my eyes. Under my eyebrows. I can't talk, to make my eyebrows stand out a little bit more, and on the tip of my nose to make it look a little bit more buttony. Now I'm going in with this powder foundation that I got from my Wantable collection this month, and I talked about it in videos before, but look at this packaging. Oh my gosh, I love Wantable. It's literally like my favorite subscription box service ever. They have the best stuff ever. It is so good. I'm gonna have a link down below. I really, really recommend you guys check it out, because this powder was like $57 and the box is like a $30 thing if you buy it like the year subscription. It is amazing. I'll have all the information down below about it. I could go on for hours about it, but I'm using this because it's a little bit lighter like my concealer, and I'm using a powder foundation to set it because it's going to make my face a little bit more full coverage, and that's what I'm aiming for. And then I'm going in with a regular translucent powder to set the rest of the parts of my face that I use with the cream contour, and this will make everything not shiny in pictures and last all night. Now I also got this blush from my Wantable collection, and it's so pretty. I'm just obsessed with all this stuff, and it's like this super hot pink blush, and I wanted to go in and contour a little bit more, so I held up my three favorite matte bronzers for contouring, and I compared the blush to each of the bronzers, and this one matched the best. It's by MAC, and it matched the best because the blush is like really hot pink and this is a warmer bronzer. So I'm contouring again. I'm just obsessed with contouring, okay? Don't judge me. I'm obsessed with contouring, and I'm going in on my cheekbones, my temples, my nose, pretty much anywhere that I put the cream contour. I'm gonna put more
more powder contour.
Now I'm taking this blush, and it's the first time I ever used it, so I was really surprised by the pigmentation of it. So I blotted that off on my hand, and then I'm applying this to the temples of my cheeks, working it up towards my forehead, and I'm really not bringing it on the apples too much. I really want it towards the back of my face because it's going to slim down my complexion a little bit, and I really like having a heavier hand with blush when it comes to photographs or a red carpet event or, you know, like prom season or something like that, because it looks really, really awesome in photos. I'm gonna highlight again because, like I said, I'm obsessed with contouring and highlighting. And this is the Porcelain Pink Mineralized Skin Finish by MAC. And I meant to put it just on the apples to give my apples like a rosy glow and just a really youthful looking glow. But I kind of got carried away and I started putting it on like the button of my nose. And then I was like, okay, I can put it on my cheekbones. Yep. So I put it on my cheekbones, out on my chin, down the bridge of my nose. I'm sorry. And of course, here I'm going to go in with my favorite eye primer ever, and this is Paint Chili Paint Pot by MAC, and this will prevent any eye shadows from creasing, make them last longer, and have the colors be more vibrant. I'm really sorry. Now we're probably gonna do the simplest smoky eye ever, and it's actually, as I was doing it, I was like, wow, this is really similar to my Vanessa Hudgens tutorial, so I'm gonna have that link down below. I'm really sorry, I didn't mean to do that, it just kind of happened, but it's really, really simple. So I'm starting off by applying a color that matches my skin tone onto my eyes just to help this eyeshadow blend a little bit more, and this is Print by MAC, and it's just a very soft charcoaly gray, and I'm applying this into the crease with a 217 by MAC, and then I'm going to go in and blend that out. Once I have that all blended out, I'm then going to go in with this color Smut on a E45 by Sigma, and I'm putting this on the outer V of my crease and on my lid. This is just going to deepen up the look a little bit more and make it a little bit more intense, kind of vamp it up a little bit, but you know, keep it a nice light smoky because we are going to put on a bolder lip. I'm now going to drag the first color Print down onto the lower lash line, and this is going to help smoke out the lower lash line. And then after that, I'm gonna go in with a reflective eyeshadow as my highlight for underneath my brow bone. I forget what this is called. I wanna say like Nylar or something like that. It's by MAC and it's so pretty. And then I'm also gonna go in with Blanc Type, and this is just going to brighten up the inner corner of the eyes just a bit and make the crease colors pop that much more. I'm now going to smoke out the upper lash line a little bit by lining the upper lash line with the color Slate by MAC, and then I'm going to take an angled brush to blend that out up into the outer corner. I'm also only lining the outer corner and sponging it to the outer corner. I'm going to try and keep the inner corner as liner free as possible, but I am going to go in and also line my waterline on the bottom and then smudge that out with the same 217 brush that we used, and it has a little bit of Print still on it, but I didn't put any more product on the brush as I was blending that out. And then I'm just going to apply some mascara to my upper and lower lashes, and then when it comes to my lower lashes, I'm just keeping them on the outer corner. I know I kind of rushed through the eyes, but like I said, it was very similar to my Vanessa Hudgens tutorial, so I'll have that link down below for a much more in-depth video about how to do a simple smoky eye. And finally, the glamorous part of the tutorial, the glossy red lips, and surprise, it's just one product, and I love this product, you guys. Oh my gosh, it also came from my Wantable collection. Seriously, thank you for this, my Wantable collection box, because without this I would have never found my holy grail red lipstick lip gloss. It is like a lip gloss, but it's so pigmented, so I think of it as like a spreadable lipstick. It is so hydrating and so moisturizing to the lips. It is so pigmented, so bold, so beautiful. I love it. You don't need lip liner, you don't need lipstick. It stays on literally all day. I am obsessed.
So thank you guys so much for watching. I really hope that you all enjoyed the video. If you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up. And also don't forget to check the description box for any extra links and extra information that I normally do put down there. So don't forget to subscribe because I upload twice a week, and I'll talk to you guys all in my next video. Bye.